Beck's birthday's coming up, so while she's out, I'm looking through our secret stash of presents to find something that's perfect for her. No. No. Uh-oh. No. But that's a fun one for me. None of these are right. Hold on. What's that? Whoa! This must be over 100 years old. And check this out. Designs for an optical illusion toy called a Thaumatrope. I think Beck will really appreciate the personal touch. Want to see how to make one? Then let's get scienced. To make this at home, you'll need some paper straws, sticky tape, scissors, colored pens or pencils, and a printout of this design. You can download a copy of this design from my website using the links in the description. Just make sure you print it onto thick paper. If you don't have thick paper, you can glue it onto some thin cardboard, like a tissue box, for added strength. Once you've printed the design, it's time to color in the pictures. This is where you can be super creative. You can use the colors I'm using, or you can use different colors. It's up to you. Next, cut around the dotted circles with a pair of scissors. Go nice and slow, or ask an adult to help you, but make sure you keep the pairs of circles together. Take one circle from each pair and tape a straw to the back of each one. I've added some dashes on the other side of these circles to show you where to tape the straw. Lastly, use some double-sided tape or glue to attach the remaining circles. Again, line up the dashes with the straw and make sure you attach the right ones together. And there it is, your very own Thaumatrope. To use it, simply place the straw between your hands and rub your hands back and forth. The snowman appears inside the snow globe, the alien flies their spaceship, and the magician makes a bunny float in midair. Awesome! So, how does it work? The Thaumatrope works thanks to persistence of vision, our brain's ability to hold onto the images we see for a fraction of a second, even after those images disappear. If I hold up this side of the Thaumatrope, light bounces off the snowman, enters our eyes, and a signal is sent to our brain. Our brain turns this signal into the image of a snowman. If we spin the Thaumatrope around, light from the image of the snow globe enters our eyes, and a new signal is sent to our brain. Our brain turns this signal into an image of a snow globe. If we spin the Thaumatrope around really quickly, our brain is still holding onto the image of the snowman when it receives the signal for the image of the snow globe. Because of this, it blends those two images together. If you want to learn more about persistence of vision, check out my video on Newton's disc. I've added a link to the description. So that's how you make a Thaumatrope, and that's how they work. Now it's time for you to try making one of these at home. You can use the designs from my website, or you can come up with completely new designs. I hope you like them as much as Beck does. I'll see you next time on Silly Science with Simon.